Racing's a singular sport, but in some cases, there is a team. The most famous of these is the 24 hours race at Le Mans. On this circuit, the world's most famous drone race is run. For 12 hours each year, man and machine are put to the supreme test of speed and stamina. There are 8 teams, 70 racers prepared to fly and destroy over 300 drones in total. To put things into perspective, most drone races are over in only 2 minutes. Mayhem.
And so, ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the most famous motor car race in the world. 24 hours of the moment.
Drop, that's the beginning of the video.
Hours before the race, the Heart of America team is brainstorming and forming their game plan. Evan, heads up, decides to make an unexpected change by flipping the front motors of his drone upside down.
Clean air, that's what we're going, that's the game we're playing here. We got clean air, we got air coming into the front motors, clean. Then super clean air going into the back motors. And more than anything, they're gonna be afraid. And that's all, that is what wins a race.
Pilots can choose any configuration for their race quads. The Heart of America team has elected to use spec racing rules for their drones. 3S half voltage batteries, which fly longer but much slower than 6S full speed and full voltage that some of the other teams will be using. The idea is if they can fly longer and have to head to the pit to switch out pilots less frequently. Is this the modern technology version of the tortoise and the hare?
Are you gonna do this 2 seconds? This
is the most Yeah, the big thing is Evan's also gonna actually charge the 435 SL. Instead of 4.2 or so.
It's like, you know, you handicap yourself going 3S, and then you're trying as hard as you can to make it faster.
Like, we're trying to beat a 6S team. We're competing within the rules.
We're within the rules.
It's gonna be the new trend.
Yeah. New hype for Mr. Steely.
Ooh!
As a first.
Full props. He's changing motor direction.
In racing, there's always an element of urgency to make changes, but safety is also a factor.
What do you say, Ivan?
It's unsafe, and also because I've seen one guy, open it up, and motors went full throttle. Props off. He had props off.
I've had like 10 clubs do it. Like, thank God I didn't have it.
That's dangerous, don't repeat it at home.
Don't
repeat it at home.
Disclaimer.
Well, he repeated it outside.
No, it's going, we're out there ripping. Yeah, we're kind of sending that resell up, you know what I'm saying? Like, I haven't wrecked, just using one quad, changing batteries. It's a blast, honestly. It's pretty fun.
So I'm flying for Team TBS, something we've been trying to do for a few years. We race in 3S on the Freedom spec. Honestly, when you get married and your time kind of goes away, and then you have to like fix 4 quads because you hit a gate and explode. With the 3S, I can just fly all day long and I break props. So you kind of get a little bit more of that like plane-to-plane racing. Makes it more about the racing and less about just, you know, full throttling everything.
It's an amazing race, insane. There's a series of emotions the pilots are going to go through. It starts off with a lot of nerves. They have high expectations. Then usually one or two of the teams, something goes wrong. So chaos ensues. It is a long and grueling race. If you look at racing in general, right, Le Mans was a big part of car racing because it really caused people to push the limits of their technology. And that's what we want to see happen here. To do what it takes to complete this race, it is by far the most difficult race there is.
J-Box!
Feeling a little windy. I'm one of those people that says the faster you go, the less the wind affects you. So you just gotta commit and you'll be fine.
I think I feel like 20 hours into the track design, testing for like mid-air potential, which is pretty hard to think about. The track's huge, 30-second laps. But it's exciting, man, to like show up to a big event, see your track to real life. Back home, the wind comes from like the west all the time. Here, it's the south. The other day, it was from the north. Like, that was like the hardest part.
Yeah, this is a nice track, and it's got some challenge.
These guys flying 6S, they can barely get 2 laps.
If someone fast, then 2 laps and you gotta land. If team got enough quads and pilots, like, then 6S is an advantage of
course.
Mayhem is one of my favorite races of the year. There's nothing like it. All the adrenaline of trying to keep the drones in the air, all the teamwork, it's just so much fun. This track is great.
I got my goggles that I won. It's good. So far we're doing good. Right on course.
50 seconds.
Like all sports, there are moves that happen between seasons. This year, the hometown team, Don't Mess With Texas, lost their two fastest pilots, LeMans and Inim Grower, that shifted over to Team Heart of America. This leaves the Texas team to slip down from fighting for midfield advantage down to fighting for sixth place, a three-way battle between Team Mamba and Team Prop Mafia. This essentially gives Team Heart of America almost a super team. Will they be able to take a win using half voltage? Individual racing occurs as well, both Freedom Spec 3S class and an open class.
Really tight right now between Amari and Chief. Chief's holding him off, but just so. Here's Amari putting the heat on. That may have been the pass.
Oh, they've gained some ground. Chief and Amari are only 3 seconds behind Heads Up FPV. Will they be able to catch him here in this final lap?
About a second and a half down, Amari slips just a touch back as we bring across our champion.
In the spec class, the Flying V takes it home. The same first, second, and third from the Drone Racing television show. Evan Heads Up Turner taking first, Alex FPV Chief taking second, and Amari coming in third. The Flying V.
J-Box wins this next race. He is your open class champion at Mayhem. Pilots, arm your quads. Live on the Tone in less than 5.
Wow, what a launch. Liam looked like he had the whole shot. It was J-Box, your current ace in the lead.
And issues for almost everybody other than J-Box. SFPV crashed into a gate. Leanne just crashed another gate. Does J-Box fly this one clean to the championship? Or does something happen open the door for Potato? Potato's given it everything he has. Will it be enough? There he gets lost at the same spot. And on the right, J-Box just won the open class at Mayhem. Third place, SFPV. Your reserve champion is Potato. And two races, two aces, your champion, the Juice Box. J-Box is your open class individual racing champion.
Congratulations, huge win. I mean, you were at this race with all of these gigantic names. How old are you?
I'm 19 right now.
Did you know you had it the whole time?
No, to be honest, I thought I was gonna crash out, just mess up somewhere.
He had the top time of the day during the 12-hour team race, so it was not a surprise. Vanover was absent from the individual racing. He went directly from the race to the premiere of the new movie Ambulance, which he shot the drone footage for.
Joe Scully live in Carrollton, Texas, on the outskirts of Dallas. Mayhem, dawn to dusk. It is dawn. All right, pilots, 20 seconds or less. Pilots, here we go. Pilot number one from all 8 teams. Arm your quads. And we go live on the Tone in less than 5. Official go tone, 10 hours, 44 minutes, 57 seconds of racing. As that sun comes up behind the hills behind us, everything is good. 8 teams, 6th edition of Mayhem. Taking a look at your leaders, and it's going to be the hometowners right now. Don't Mess With Texas, your leaders after one lap, and your fastest lap of the morning, 29.5. Now, it's going to be tight, and oh no, we're seeing some crashing, not even some pit maneuvers yet. Don't Mess With Texas now launching a new pilot out, so that's going to put White Goat up in the lead. They come into pit legit. J-Box coming in for Team White Goat as they launch their next pilot.
Glancing at the leaderboard, Team Heart of America, now just 8 laps ahead of third place, Quad Force 1, 726 to 718. Team Black Sheep bringing in fourth place, 691, 4 laps ahead of Team Velocidrome. It's getting pretty tight between 4 and 5 right now. I bet it's the tightest gap on the table. Velocidrome Prop Mafia also a rather tight gap at only 6 laps and change.
We're in fifth place right now, just trying to catch up. Starting off a little shaky, but we're in a good flow now, so.
White Goat may have the record here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 pit penalties. That was Heart of America squeezing the last 5 minutes out. So when we go to sudden death, 9.5 minutes. PBS and Velocidrone are a lap apart, but racing together blade to blade. We got 2 minutes to go.
Ladies and gentlemen, we are in the final minute of Mayhem 2022.
We're getting ready to wave a checker flag.
So right now, Velocidrone needs a very fast lap. Doesn't look like they're going to be able to get around one more time.
There is your final countdown to bring out the checkered flag. The 2022 Mayhem Dawn to Dusk completes. Finish up the laps that you are on, and we get set to crown your champions. There's Brock Mafia over across the line in sixth. Heart of America across the line in second. Mamba across the line in eighth. Velocidrone in the number five spot overall. Quad Force One rounding out our podium in third. Team Black Sheep about to finish up in the number four position. Your hometowners, Don't Mess With Texas, finishing up in seventh, and they're already spiking quads. Your 2022 Mayhem champion. Team White Goats.
We just had a great race for fourth. I never have been so excited to be like, we came in fourth! But it was just such an awesome job working with the team together to make it all happen. I'm so thankful for these guys. Thankful for our team captain over here. Yeah, it was a great battle with Velocidrone. We both deserve that position. They gave it everything we needed.
And our battle at the beginning of the day with Quad Force One,
yeah,
that was epic. Like, we were holding third place for a lot of the day, but they were running 6S once they got into their rhythm, and they were running 25, 26 second laps. Like, on 3S, we just can't catch up.
And I didn't break anything but props the whole day flying 3S. And now, fancy transition.
Dude, it was a long day. I think I had like one 30 minute break, and then I was just on it the whole time. I was basically in the rotation the whole time. We cranked it, it was fun. We had a great battle with TBS.
I think he had his favorite time. What was that, Thursday night at Fogo de Gao?
Spend $80 for a piece of meat.
First time represented here at Mayhem. Quad Force One. To reserve champions, Heart of America.
Texas! Mood in our pits was different because we were chasing him. We were behind the whole time. Big time thank you. They're not on the podium, but both Team TBS and Velocidrone took that three spec journey with us, so it was really a battle between us. But seeing what Team White Goat was able to pull off, it was really cool to see him really along with like J-Box and Fire Surfer and Aether that day.
It was a blast. Couldn't be happier. I came out like 14 shades redder. My face at least. You couldn't ask for anything better. Great event. And I mean, like the battle between Velocidrone and TBS, you know, that was freedom spec. And I didn't see any open class races that were any closer than that. So, you know, it did its thing and it was awesome. We beat as many teams as we could, you know.
Oh yeah.
White Goat got ahead and they did some amazing things, but we were happy with how we did it. It was awesome to watch. And we didn't break anything. I used the same two quads all day. So last year I brought 12 quads. I left with no quads and 30 batteries and I left with no batteries. But that was like everything we had, full throttle the whole time. Both have their place. I'm excited for both. I'm here for it all. So.
These guys saw the flying and the lack of crashing and the unbelievable go fast these guys were.
2022 Mayhem Champions, Team White Goats.
White Goats!
You need a steerhead if you have been to Texas. That'll be up in the Team White Goat Lodge there on proud display. The trophy signifying your 2022 Mayhem From Dawn Till Dusk Champions. Team Captain, the only pilot here out of the 69 competing pilots that has competed at every single Mayhem, Lundy, congratulations. Second win for White Goat. This one must be a little more special for you guys.
Definitely a battle that we all survived. Those guys definitely gave it to us, you know, with 3S. It was a tough run. We all flew past every single member of our team. It was nice. Thank you guys for flying 3S. It gave us a little relaxing. We were over there relaxing. You know, you guys were talking about, y'all didn't break anything. We didn't break much either. Our batteries are surprisingly okay, we're not doing this for the rest of the season, so thank you. We want to say thank you to Shannon for always doing this. And I've been a believer in team racing, obviously, since the beginning.
In the end, the up-and-coming stars of J-Box and Team White Goat proved that today, full voltage is still faster. However, the experiment was still a success. Heart of America, with the half voltage spec, did still finish second ahead of other full voltage teams, proving that the slower form of racing, which focuses on beautiful lines to shave off seconds and less trips to the pit to change batteries, can be competitive. Mayhem is a race like no other. There's no money on the line, but there's something much greater: bragging rights and pride. And being a part of the winning team that gets to hold that championship for the next year. Until the next time, all of the races assemble for 12 hours of mayhem.
I guess 6S is faster. Okay.
Yeah, I don't think you gotta be a mathematician to figure that one out. But I'm gonna be honest, I'm really surprised that HOA, they're second. And they're
so while
TBS or a few other teams were doing mixed and they still had a B. So I think it really came down to like client efficient and then the pitting strategies. That played a big factor.
What go?
Yeah, well, you were coming out with some fast laps, like breaking your time multiple times.
Yeah. 5.0.
What?
Yep.
Holy crap.
I'd only get two laps and the thing was done. I had to come land right away.
Two really fast laps. Man, congratulations.
Thank you a lot.
Nice performance, man.
Thank you.
That's really awesome.